Hi, my name is Dr. John Shim, and I want to discuss anterior cervical discectomy and fusion surgery. At this point, you have already failed non-surgical treatments and have decided to move forward with the operation. When we reviewed your diagnostic studies, the main reason this surgery is offered is secondary to disc herniations or bone spurs that cause entrapment of the nerves and cause associated nerve pain, numbness, or weakness. Let me show you a typical cervical MRI of a disc herniation. This is the sagittal view. It shows the neck from the side. For most patients, there are some normal disc levels identified, but the offending disc shows a mass pushing backwards onto the spinal canal and nerves or spinal cord. On this axial view or cross-sectional view, you can see the disc material coming out of the outer layers of the disc or the annulus and causing pressure on the thecal sac, the spinal nerves, and the spinal cord. For most patients, this will cause radiating pain and numbness in a specific pattern. These numbness and sensation patterns are called dermatomes. They are often associated with reflex and muscle strength findings. For some patients, there's more than one disc level of involvement. Surgery is performed through an incision on the front of the neck. Care is taken to dissect safely between the intervals between various muscle groups. Care is taken to protect the windpipe, the food pipe, and the arteries and veins. Once the bones of the front of the neck are exposed, the disc herniation is removed from the disc space, taking pressure off the thecal sac, the individual nerves, and/or the spinal cord. Compressing bone spurs can also be removed. The bone edges are scraped clear of all soft tissue and contoured appropriately to accept the bone graft or cage. Once measured, the appropriate size graft is placed in the disc space. Some patients will have more than one disc removed during the operation. Plates and screws are used to secure the bone graft in the disc space and provide stability while the bone grows into the graft. Once fused, the plates and screws are not necessary, but it is rare to remove the plates and screws unless there is an issue. The incision is closed. Depending on the circumstance, a cervical collar may be recommended. Depending on the circumstance, your surgeon may restrict certain activities for a certain time. The operation has a high success rate, and most patients will be able to return back to the activities after several months. This is the basic animation of the operation. You should discuss your individual concerns with your surgeon. This is Dr. John Shim, and I hope this video was helpful for your understanding of the anterior cervical discectomy and fusion operation. Thank you.